Good day, fellow disciple of Christ. Welcome to prayer for Friday, April the 9th. We begin with a deep breath and then our introductory responses for the resurrection season. The second line is yours. We begin. Alleluia. Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Together. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Praise the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. He gave us new life and hope by raising Jesus from the dead. Together, he gave us new life and hope by raising Jesus from the dead. Rejoice then, even in your distress. We shall be counted worthy when Christ appears. Together, we shall be counted worthy when Christ appears. God has claimed us as his own. He called us from our darkness into the light of his day. Together, he called us from our darkness into the light of his day. Alleluia, Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia, together, the Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let us pray. Lord of life and power, through the mighty resurrection of your Son, you have overcome the old order of sin and death and have made all things new in him. May we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, reign with him in glory, who with you and the Holy Spirit is alive, one God, now and forever. Amen. Psalm 136 is a liturgical psalm given in call and response. This psalm celebrates God's salvation actions on the behalf of the people of Israel, and we can insert ourselves in this salvation story as well. We will be praying verses 1 to 16 and 22 to 26. Every line is responded to with the same response, "For his mercy endures forever." So you are invited to join me in that response. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the God of gods, for his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of lords, for his mercy endures forever. Who only does great wonders, for his mercy endures forever. Who by his wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endures forever. Who spread out the earth upon the waters, for his mercy endures forever. Who created great lights, for his mercy endures forever. The sun to rule the day, for his mercy endures forever. The moon and the stars to govern the night, for his mercy endures forever. Who struck down the firstborn of Egypt, for his mercy endures forever. And brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy endures forever. With a mighty hand and an outstretched arm, for his mercy endures forever. Who divided the Red Sea in two, for his mercy endures forever. And made Israel to pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endures forever. But swept Pharaoh and his army into the sea, for his mercy endures forever. Who led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endures forever. Who remembered us in our low estate, for his mercy endures forever. And delivered us from our enemies, for his mercy endures forever. Who gives food to all creatures, for his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the God of heaven, for his mercy endures forever. Let us pray. Maker and sustainer of all things, source of all life and goodness, help us always to love and serve one another and to worship you with joy and gladness through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Peter is preaching to the gathered crowd in Jerusalem, reminding them of their responsibility in the death of Jesus, but also that through Messiah, God had a desire to bless the descendants of all the families of the earth. We pick up in chapter 4, verses 1 through 12, when Peter and John are still preaching. While Peter and John were speaking to the people, the priests, the captain of the temple, and the Sadducees came to them, much annoyed because they were teaching the people and proclaiming that in Jesus there is the resurrection of the dead. So they arrested them and put them in custody until the next day, for it was already evening. But many of those who heard the word believed, and they numbered about 5,000. The next day, their rulers, elders, and scribes assembled in Jerusalem with Annas, the high priest, Caiaphas, John, and Alexander, and all were of the high priestly family. When they had made the prisoners stand in their midst, they inquired, "By what power or by what name did you do this?" Then Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "Rulers of the people and elders, if we are questioned today because of the good deed done to someone who was sick, and are asked how this man has been healed, let it be known to all of you and to all the people of Israel that this man is standing before you in this good health by the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. This Jesus is the stone that was rejected by you, the builders. It has become the chief cornerstone. There is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven given among mortals by which we must be saved." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Don't you just love and admire the boldness of Peter? Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said to them, "There is no other name by which we must be saved." So bold, so courageous. Remember, friends, that this was a gift of the Holy Spirit for Peter. This doesn't mean that we can't ask for this gift of the Spirit, that we might be a bit more bold in our own Christian walk. I find that as Anglicans, we almost are publicly apologetic for the faith that we hold within, instead of boldly proclaiming the good news of Jesus, the Savior of all humanity. If there are two ditches we can fall in while we are considering the idea of sharing our faith, one would be of quiet shyness, and the other would be of an extroverted insensitivity to others, a fear of, quote, shoving religion down people's throats, people who don't want to listen. If we are to err on one side, one ditch or the other, for most Anglicans, it certainly would be that we are shy in our faith and not overly bold and obnoxious. The best way to be prepared to share our faith is to be a prayerful person, so that, like Peter, filled with the Spirit at the right time with the right words, we can make witness to the goodness of God and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus. In my experience, there are few times in one's life when there's a divine appointment, a meeting with another person that seems set up by God in order for faith sharing to happen. These are deeply personal and wonderful, beautiful moments of spiritual intimacy. They truly are gifts of the Spirit, and in my experience, pretty rare too. But let it be our intention to be ready to share when the Spirit calls us and equips us so to do. By grace, may the Lord move us by the breath of His Spirit. Amen. In joy and hope, let us pray to the source of all life, saying, "Hear us, Lord of glory." And this is given with an exclamation point. Hear us, Lord of glory. It's almost a shout to God. Again, and I know this sounds very un-Anglican, but we can shout our prayer to God. And if you're in a quiet place or you're alone, I encourage you to make the exclamation point come alive in your prayers. Let us take a deep breath and pray that our risen Savior may fill us with the joy of his holy and life-giving resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory, that isolated and persecuted churches may find fresh strength in the Easter gospel. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory, that God may grant us the humility to be subject to one another in Christian love. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory, that he may provide for those who lack food, work, or shelter. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory, that by his power, wars, famine, and pandemic may cease through all the earth. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory, that God may reveal the light of his presence to the sick, the weak, the isolated, the dying, that they may be comforted and strengthened. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory, that he may send the fire of the Holy Spirit upon his people, that we may bear faithful witness to his resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord, hear us, Lord of glory. Gathering all our prayers and praises into one, let us pray as our Savior taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Beloved, let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. My friends, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious toward you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and grant you peace this day and forevermore, abiding in the blessing of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Have a blessed day.